وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
My brother is very relaxed when it comes to free mixing between myself and his wife. Sometimes he will leave me in the house alone with her and I don't know how to advise him. Please help.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In response to your question, I want to say that the asal في الحم, the asal regarding the illu is ألا يرد على النساء الأجنبيات. He should not enter onto the non-mahram women. And this is based on the hadith that Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated من حديث عقبة بن عامر رضي الله تعالى عنه that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he said إياكم والدخول على النساء, stay away from entering upon the women. فقال رجل من الأنصار أيمن, from the people of Ansar, he said يا رسول الله أفرأيت الحم, what about the in-law? The prophet he said الحم موت, he's death, he is death. So the woman, she should not be talking to her brother-in-law and speaking to him freely and laughing with him. And some of the scholars, they hold the opinion that the sawt of the woman, the sound of the woman, her voice is awra. Some of the scholars hold that opinion, even though it's a weak opinion. But there is a view that out there that says that the woman's voice is awra and that she can only speak to men when there is a need or a hajah for it. That view does seem to be weak. But to be on the safe side, it is best to avoid talking to any man that there is no hajah, there is no need for it. Also, the in-law should not stay in the house with a woman by himself, because this could lead to something very evil. And the brother should advise his brother if he sees him being free with his wife, allowing her to sit with who she wants and do what she wants. He should advise him and he should talk to his brother and advise him. And inshallah ta'ala, hopefully that reminder that you give to your brother may be a means of rectification for him. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, فَذَكِّرْ إِن نَفَعَتِ الذِّكْرَى. And he remind if the reminder benefits. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind, for verily the reminder benefits the believers. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to guide us to that which is best. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdi ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
If you have any questions you'd like to see answered as part of this series, then you can email us at questions@amau.org.